All right, so tell me what you think about this mural here.
I think this mural is really, really dope. It's by Ella Inspires. She's a really, really cool Latina artist from East Boston, and love to see her work here.
All right, cool. It's called Mind Over Matter, right?
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna back up and get a better view of it. This is gonna be on my YouTube channel called External Affairs Porter.
External Fears?
External Affairs Porter.
Okay, I'll look it up.
All right.
Okay, nice meeting you.
Take care, have a good one. All right, so they got a nice Mind Over Matter. I can get a better view of that. This is right down here by Dougley. Yeah.
You like it?
Yeah, it's good. Perfect. She was just telling me about the artist who did it. So that's, I like it.
Yep.
Positive thinking. And this is the artist who did it. But they also have a little thing for Mara Haley over here. IB Local 103. International Brotherhood. Let's see what they have over here for Mara Haley. Take a quick look around and see what they got. A lot of people showing up. People from all walks of life. Just gonna kind of mingle in the crowd a little bit and see what's going on. Might see some familiar faces, but I won't say too much. Good morning, how you doing? All right, good, good. Got the IB Local 103 here.
All
right.
There
we go.
Thank you.
Just want to give you guys a kind of idea what they have going on. We have pastries if you want, donuts and coffee, muffins and whatnot. Hey, what's happening? How you doing?
Good.
All right.
Hello. Looks like a lot of you are behind me now, but thank you, sisters and brothers, for joining us today. Another beautiful Saturday. You're spending time making working people's voices heard. Thank you for being out here with us. So if you could all just sign in over here at the sign-in table, get your turf, so that way when we're done with the speaking program, we can go out and hit doors, and then come over and gather over here. This is where the speaking program is going to take place. Thank you all for being here. We'll get going in a few minutes.
That's okay. Do your thing.
Hey, how you doing? Yeah, we're making
hang around for a little bit and see what they got going on. You might see some familiar faces out here. Here comes the crew coming through here. It's a pretty good crowd, you know.
My wife.
What's up? How you doing? Good morning.
Okay. Is that Maya? Yeah. Keep all the lettuce together.
Yeah. Guys, Mike, can we slide down?
If you can keep coming down, we can fill in down here.
I'm behind.
That's okay.
I think we only have one. I think one person has it.
Labor Council. We represent over 100,000 workers here and their families. Some of them living right here in the burn. So I wanted to introduce, to kick us off, some incredible speakers this morning, but this we wanted to start. Some of these gatherings, it's widely believed that the Lion Dance will bring good fortune, happiness, success, and prosperity to the places, gatherings, and businesses at hand. Walloon Kung Fu and Tai Chi Academy drumming and lion dance troupe has shown up to countless community social events and rallies to invigorate and amplify the many impactful messages from, by, and for the people of Massachusetts. Their team is, we're so proud to be hosting them, and they're proud to be here to support yes on question one, and yes, yes, yes on question four. So please welcome Walloon Kung Fu Academy.
Thank you.
Brothers, get that up there. Good morning, sisters and brothers.
Morning.
It is an honor to be with you on this glorious Saturday morning and to see the luck that they brought us on questions 1 and 4 and all of our statewide candidates. It's an honor to be the president of the Massachusetts AFL-CIO, and we have been out for months talking to voters about our endorsed champions, our priority ballot questions, and we are going to finish this election strong, sisters and brothers. Voting yes on 1 and yes on 4 will provide real resources and opportunities for working people across the Commonwealth, and the Massachusetts AFL-CIO is proud to stand with these crucial campaigns at a time. And it is my honor to introduce somebody who has spent her entire career standing with working families, whether here at home or on the floor of Congress. Nobody has worked or has our backs more than our Congresswoman Ayanna Pressley. Let's give it up for our endorsed Congresswoman of the 7th Congressional District, Ayanna Pressley.
All right, thank you, President Tolman. Thank you again to Solomon Chodorai. Thank you to the Dudley Cafe. You really model exactly what our hope was for this business, which is really the heart of the community, a meeting place. You've been an incredible partner on so many issues. It's good to be with all of you, family. It's so important that we are in community and that we continue to organize, because organized power is realized power. And we need that realized power in those investments now more than ever. At a time of unprecedented challenge for our Commonwealth and our country, whether you're talking about the impacts of this pandemic-induced recession, of which we are still recovering, or whether you're talking about the violence that we are grappling with from our neighborhoods all the way to Capitol Hill. This time of unprecedented challenge really does demand of us unprecedented organizing, unprecedented political will and courage, and unprecedented investment. It is my great and humbling honor to be the Congresswoman representing the Massachusetts 7th Congressional District. A district that is vibrant, diverse, dynamic, because all of you, and one of the most unequal congressional districts in the country, and the most unequal in our delegation. In 2018, I ran on a mandate that change can't wait. It still can't. Public transit featured prominently in my campaign. You may recall us talking about the disparities from Cambridge and Harvard Square all the way to Roxbury Nubian Square, and you could see all of that on the number one bus. These disparities. The thing of it is every inequity, every disparity, Every racial injustice is one that was codified in a budget or in a law. And that's why the way to undo this harm and to chart a brighter and more equitable and just path forward has everything to do with, one, our who takes over this corner office in a matter of days, and our constitutional officers. So I do want to take a moment, as someone for whom policy is my love language, I want to give it up to two incredible champions. I'm so proud of the history that we are poised to make with Mara Healy and Andrea Campbell. Two leaders who I know understand that a budget is truly a statement and meant to be a reflection of our values. I also want to give it up to our partners in labor. While I stand here on the heels of our having worked so closely together, arm in arm, having delivered a victory on student debt relief and cancellation, I want to give it up to the labor movement, my brothers and sisters. Thank you, President Tolman. Thank you to all our partners in labor who were a part of this broad and diverse coalition to make the case that change could not wait for relief and cancellation, because student debt is an issue that affects people from every walk of life. So what that victory proves is that it is always impossible until it is done. And victories are only made possible through organizing and through movements. We need to vote yes on one and mobilize people in voting yes on one, because it is high time that millionaires pay their fair share. This is one of the most unequal districts because of divestment and under-resourcing. And public education and public transit are our two most important infrastructures. One, to invest in our people. That is our greatest infrastructure, to invest in our human capital, in our education. That's about workforce and our competitiveness. And it's also a matter of fairness and justice and equality. And to invest in our public transit, to ensure that, one, we are meeting our economic justice goals, closing the racial wealth gap, connecting people to jobs, to health care, to child care, to education. So yes on one is a yes for equity, for fairness, and justice. And then finally, yes on four. It's so important that this coalition and this movement educate voters on this question, because there's a lot of fear-mongering and misinformation. At the end of the day, as I fight for these investments federally as the co-chair of the caucus for the future of transportation, and as an original co-sponsor with Senator Ed Markey on a bill called the Freedom to Move, everyone at the most basic level deserves the freedom to move. And we want that to happen safely. We are all better served when those that are on the roads are licensed, tested, and insured. Amen. So this is about safety. This is also about fairness. And this is also about economic mobility. For anyone who calls the Commonwealth their home, for the residents of this Commonwealth, regardless of your immigration status, you deserve the freedom to move. So yes on one, and yes on four, and yes to the power of this coalition and this movement. It is always impossible until it is done. Let's get it done.
Sisters and brothers, true to form, Congressman Presley, nobody worked harder with Elizabeth Warren on that student debt relief than Congressman Presley. Let's give it up for her and her leadership. We have some electeds here. We have our Suffolk County DA, Kevin Hagan. Kevin Hagan, where are you? Kevin, right over here. We have City Councilor Evan Murphy. City Councilor John Drinkwater. And we have Julia Beehive. Join Boston City Council. There's a lot of vice presidents here from the Mass AFL-CIO sisters and brothers in a lot of different unions. But more importantly, it's great to see the community and organized labor working together for a common goal, which is going to make us all stronger. So thank you. And thank you so much to Congresswoman Presley. Up next, we have the campaign manager on Yes on One, the Fair Share Amendment. It will invest, as Ayanna just said, nearly $2 billion per year in roads and bridges. Sisters and brothers, this is on top of the federal money that is one-time federal money. Do not be fooled by those foolish commercials who want you to believe that it's going to affect the middle class. This is going to attack the workers, excuse me, the millionaires who can easily afford the money for question one. And I am proud to say that we have the right campaign manager. Hello, Haran Mariani worked with the AFL-CIO as an intern. He comes to us with so much experience and so much commitment and so much dedication. Let's give it up for Haran. Come on.
Good morning, Massachusetts. How we feeling? I am so filled with hope and joy this morning because that is what our coalition is all about. The Yes on One campaign and the Yes on Four campaign going hand in hand into November 8th to deliver fairness, equity, and justice for Massachusetts. This is a historic moment and I couldn't be more excited to be sharing it with all of you. The Fair Share Amendment, or question one, simply put, is an opportunity. It's an opportunity to make the critically needed investments in public education, in transportation, that we have ignored for so long in our Commonwealth. Across Massachusetts, there are over 600 structurally deficient bridges. Is that acceptable?
No!
We must make these investments so that the Orange Line is not on fire and shut down for over a month. So that when you're driving on roads, you don't hit a pothole, lose your tire, and have to pay it out of pocket. So that when you're going over or under a bridge, you know without a shadow of a doubt that you are safe on Massachusetts roads. We must make these investments, and by not doing it, we have allowed our system to fall into disarray. It's time to fix that, and the Fair Share Amendment will do it. This is a historic moment for Massachusetts. The Fair Share Amendment campaign has been a life's work for many people in our coalition, probably people in this crowd as well. Over 100 years ago, our tax system was written with a 5% flat tax because millionaires, billionaires, and corporate interests knew that it saved them more money at the end of the day. It is unfair. The wealthiest 1% in Massachusetts pay a lower share of their income in state and local taxes than working people. The system is upside down. And the Fair Share Amendment is our opportunity. We have attempted it 5 times in the last 100 years. And like we all say, the 6th time is the charm, y'all. We're gonna get this done, and we're gonna get it done absolutely together. So thank you all for being here. Thank you for coming out in support of question one, for coming out in support of question four. Yes on one, yes on four. Let's get this done together. Thank you, everybody.
And four is up next, sisters and brothers. As we move to question four, we must remember that it's going to make our roads safer by giving all the drivers an opportunity to get a driver's license by taking the classes and prove to somebody they're a safe driver. That's what this is about. And then when they're a safe driver, they'll be able to be properly insured. That's all this is. This is a humanitarian issue. This is God. What people want to do to divide us and say, oh, that's foolish. It's not foolish. It's long overdue. And sisters and brothers, I am proud to introduce a tireless community partner who has been a longtime champion of this issue and many others on behalf of workers and their families. sisters and brothers, let's give it up for Mimi Ramos.
Good morning, everyone. We got a whole community standing up together on this issue, so just give us a moment. We're gonna ask folks to come on stage who can.
All right.
Well, good morning, everyone. My name is Mimi Ramos. I'm a proud member of Right to the City Vote, a multiracial, multigenerational, and multicultural alliance that represents Black, Brown, and API communities across Boston. But I'm also here as a proud member and supporter of the 17-year fight that Driving Mass Families Forward Coalition has stood on this particular issue. So let's please give it up for the coalition residents who have been fighting for question four for the past 17 years. We are here to take a stance on the Work and Family Mobility Act. And we are here to encourage voters to vote yes on ballot question number four. This ballot question was not in our red books. Let me say that again. This ballot question was not in our red books, but it will be on everyone's ballot this year. And we encourage folks that as we go and vote, as November 8 is around the corner, to pay attention to question four, make sure to flip the ballots. Some ballots will have two pages, but make sure that we are paying attention and that we are voting and voting for justice. The Work and Family Mobility Act is simple. It's straightforward, and we want to be clear about what this issue represents. It is a simple measure that will ensure that everyone in Massachusetts has access to a driver's license. I know that many of us deserve the right to drive our children to schools, to get to the grocery store, to go back and forth to work, and even to see our doctors. That is no different for this fight, and we want to ensure that everyone has access to a driver's license. This does not change, and we want to be clear, the process of how residents apply. Immigrant families will be applying for a license, will need to go through the same process, providing their identity, Massachusetts residency, and will pass the required test. We are very lucky to have a diverse representation here in the city of Boston. Whatever their immigrant status may be, these families are a part of our communities, and we are proud to stand together to ensure that immigrant families have the same right and access as all of us. Are you with me in saying vote yes to question four? Are you with me in saying yes to question four? This is about safer roads and justice for us all. 16 other states have passed and implemented legislation around this issue. California and Connecticut saw significantly fewer hit and run crashes. New Mexico saw a 60% drop in uninsured drivers. And in New York, just measured a 50% drop in charges of driving without a license. Massachusetts has a blueprint to do this right. And we as voters have a duty and a responsibility to stand up on this issue and vote what?
Yes.
And vote what?
Yes.
And vote what?
Yes.
Yes on question four. We are proud to stand with our allies in community who have led this charge, with labor allies, with our elected officials. We are also proud that DAs and sheriffs and police chiefs are standing on the right side of this issue. So let's give it up, y'all. Remember, November 8th, yes on?
Four.
Yes on?
Four.
Yes on?
Four.
Let's do it, y'all.
Yes on four.
Yes on four.
Are you fired up?
Yeah!
I understand Ruth Z's here, our Boston City Council. Where's Ruth Z? She's here somewhere. Ah, come on, Ruth Z! Where are you? There you are. Sisters and brothers, thank you, Mimi. Thank you for all the leadership that you have provided on this issue. And up next, sisters and brothers, we have a candidate that's no stranger to any of us. No stranger at all. She has been standing up for vital, important issues for working people for years, whether it's leading the charge against wage theft or standing with our most vulnerable workers and their families. We know that our sister Andrea Campbell is gonna make a great Attorney General. Let's give it up for the next Attorney General for Massachusetts, Andrea Campbell!
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
All right, we can do better than that. We're about to make history in Massachusetts. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I don't know about you, but I am fired up. Fired up. We have the opportunity in the next 10 days to elect the first woman and first LGBTQ governor in Massachusetts. I'm fired up. We have the first. We have the opportunity in the next 10 days to bring in a dual LG and governor and two women. That is the first in the country for a woman to occupy the LG's office as well as the governor's office. Massachusetts, we're on the verge of making history. We have the opportunity to not only vote yes on question one, but to demonstrate that we are for equity and fairness when it comes to economics. That is historic. That has me fired up. We have the opportunity to vote yes on question four. Not just to say we're gonna stand with our immigrant communities, but we're gonna take action to actually deliver something they've been fighting for almost two decades. That has me fired up. Thank you to both coalitions for the hard work they're doing to not only stand up, but to mobilize people all across the state. I am really honored and grateful to be here with all of you. I'm grateful to labor that is fighting every single day, not just the building trades, SEIU, our service organizations who've been out here every single day on the front lines throughout this pandemic to make sure every worker is taken care of and will thrive and prosper coming out of COVID. I consider it an honor and a privilege to be the Democratic nominee for Attorney General, because it's not lost on me that if we get this right in the next 10 days, I will be the first Black woman and the first woman of color to win statewide office in Massachusetts. That has me. And so for the next 10 days, we are not slowing down and we are not taking anything or anyone for granted. I leave from here and I head out to Western Mass, communities that often feel left out and left behind, because the work continues. It is very emotional, but in a joyful way, to be standing here. This is the neighborhood in which I grew up, Roxbury, South End, Dudley. And what we did to be successful in this AG race, we got out and said a few things. One is that this race is important. If you care about the Supreme Court and reproductive justice, immigrant rights, labor rights, you should care about this race. If you care about economic justice and prosperity, taking on racial discrimination, taking on hate crimes, making sure that you can afford a home in Massachusetts, but all other things you're buying, that you can afford those things too, you should care about the AG race. If you care about community violence and making sure we're breaking cycles of poverty, trauma, and violence in our communities and every gateway community across Massachusetts, you should care about this race. If you care about wage theft, people actually going to work and not getting paid their hard-earned dollars, you should care about the Attorney General race. If you care about the well-being of our children, the uptick in depression, anxiety, and suicide that we're seeing amongst our kids, you should care about this race. And I'm only scratching the surface of why you should care about this race. And so I got out there to say, not only am I the best candidate, but I could relate to many of those struggles. I grew up poor in this neighborhood, in public housing. All of my biological parents are deceased. All of my biological grandparents are deceased. And many of you know my twin brother died 10 years ago while in the Department of Correction when he was only 29 years old as a result of receiving inadequate health care. But I want to do more than just reflect or relate to the stories of constituents. I want to make sure that government is responsive to your needs and delivers real solutions to help you. And this is why the Attorney General's office is so damn special. I'm going to be real frank. There are millions of dollars in this office, hundreds of talented lawyers and staff that on a day-to-day basis can make sure you have a place to live that is affordable, that is sound, to make sure that our immigrant communities are not only seen but are protected, to make sure that economic prosperity reaches every corner of the Commonwealth, to take on wage disparity and wage theft with significant aggression, to make sure that labor has a voice in what we're doing, to make sure as there's an uptick in hate crimes that we are not mincing our words and going after those who perpetuate crime in our community. There is so much, but to get there, we got 10 days. So when I say I'm fired up, 10 days to mobilize more people, door knocking, phone banking, to get people to show up. Because when we do that, Massachusetts won't only lead on the issues, we will lead this nation. No other state in the Commonwealth has done what we've done. Look around, brought together diverse coalitions to work in partnership of every stripe, every demographic, brought together rural communities with our urban centers to get things done. If you haven't looked around, look around. This is what Massachusetts looks like. 10 days, and I promise you, when we get over that finish line, I will always be a partner in the work. Thank you very much, Andrea Campbell. Honored to be here. Thank you.
Thank you, Andrea. There we go. I better get rid of this probably. Listen, sisters and brothers, the one we've been waiting for, our Attorney General, who has never been afraid of a fight and is used to standing up for work and families, who wasn't afraid to challenge the companies in the opiate addiction. And when they tried to settle too early, she didn't let them up. She put her foot on the neck of the corporations that poisoned our communities for the last 20 years. Sisters and brothers, there's nobody like our next candidate who is going to be our governor. We are going to see a change in the Commonwealth, a brighter future, a greener future. And with those green jobs, she's going to make sure they're good union jobs for all families. Sisters and brothers, let's give it up for our Attorney General and our next governor of the Massachusetts, Maura Healey.
Square. It is so awesome to be here with all of you. It is amazing and splendid to see so many people out this morning. This is what it's all about. We've got 10 days left. Thank you, President Tolman, Darlene Lambos, all the folks from Labor who've come out today. I also want to thank the folks from Yes on One and Yes on Four. We're going to talk about that. Thank you for being out because we're going to get this done. Also, thank you to my sisters in service. Beginning with Ayanna Pressley. You know, Ayanna and I have worked together on issue after issue for a good number of years. And Ayanna is just an incredible fighter for justice, for equality. Just this week, she was around the state doing the hard work of signing student borrowers up for much needed debt relief that she was able to get passed and able to make happen with the Biden administration. Just one example of her incredibly important work and how she's changing the lives of people, not just in the district, not just across Massachusetts, but all across the country. Ayanna, we love you. Thank you so much for what you do. And how about Andrea Campbell? Massachusetts, you have a chance to make history, electing the first black woman statewide and to the office of Attorney General. We're going to go make that happen. I'll tell you, representation matters. Seeing is believing. And we have somebody who's charged with making sure that our laws are enforced equally and fairly. I can't think of a better person than Andrea Campbell. So I want you to do all you can to get the word out and turn the vote out for our next Attorney General, Andrea Campbell. And we've got got great candidates up and down the ballot, who are going to be about delivering for people, not dividing them. And that's what we've got to remind people of. We're also here today to talk about a couple of really important measures. Yes on one. Absolutely yes on one. We need the revenue, the funding for infrastructure and education. It's as simple as that. These things are so foundational. In a state, the Commonwealth, home to the first public school in the country, home to the first public library in the country, home to the place that put education in its constitution. It's how much we value it. But we know more investments are needed, especially to deal with some of the disparities that have persisted for far too long, only exacerbated through the COVID pandemic. But now is the time. We can be so much more in Boston and Massachusetts, and we can lead the way across this country in a time where people are feeling sometimes without hope, without loss, so much pain, so much suffering the last few years. But now is the time to take that on by getting out to vote. Yes on one. You know, yes on four. Yes on four. I say that as your Attorney General, knowing something about public safety. This is a matter of public safety. And this is a matter of making sure that we know who is on the roads, that we know that they are trained, and in fact, if they have a car, they're gonna actually have access to insurance. It's a no-brainer, which is why 17 other states already do this and make this happen, including states like Utah. If Utah can do it, I think the great Commonwealth of Massachusetts can get it done as well. So get out there, yes on four, yes on one. So I want everybody going over and getting packets and doing the walk today. And if you're unable to do that, and you can get on the phones and do some dialing, if you can get the word out through your own networks, talk to friends, talk to family. We know that early voting is happening right now. You can still apply to vote by mail. And of course, we want everybody to have a plan for November 8th. But let me just bring it back. You know, I stand before you as somebody who never, ever expected to be here. 15 years ago, I left private practice. One of the first people I worked with was Victoria Williams. And we were doing fair housing work here in the city and fighting discrimination. And, you know, I think about all the work that so many of us have done together over the years. This is the time to bring it home. Whether it was housing justice, or healthcare justice, or environmental justice, or reproductive justice, or transportation justice. So many of you have fought for so long on so many issues. And now is the time, this election, Massachusetts, to bring it home. I know there's not an energy issue or an enthusiasm issue, because people care. People have been working and fighting and struggling long, long, long time on these issues. And this is what it's all about. November 8th, this election, with the candidates that we're going to elect, and with the ballot measures that we're going to pass. This is a time when all that you've worked for is going to come home. We talked about this ballot too, what it represents. First time in this country that this country will see a state with two women at the top. Never happened before. Representation matters. Especially in a time when some out there are pushing for nationwide abortion bans and trying to take freedoms and rights away. Massachusetts, we're gonna stand up strong, and we're gonna face up to that and just say no. Just say no. You know, I think about the real challenges, and I see them in this neighborhood. I see them in neighborhoods and cities and towns across the state. I know that people are hurting. We need more housing, and we're gonna fix that. We're gonna create more housing all over the state. We need to fix our public transit system so that it is fair, safe, and affordable. We need to invest in our childcare and in our workforce. We need to fund education and mental health services, big time, and services for substance use disorder. All of these things. But we are only going to be able to do these things if we do the work together the next 10 days. If we get the numbers up, if we turn the vote out. And also in doing so, and I look at our dancers who performed, this is what it's about. It's about the young people. The young people dancing behind you. We have an obligation. We have an obligation to help people through what at times is a feeling of malaise or hopelessness. And it's understandable when you look at some of the things that are happening across this country, the rise of white supremacy, the rise of election deniers running for statewide offices all across this land, the vitriol and the exploitation of hate by certain politicians, including certain governors. So it's understandable that people are feeling like government isn't there for them, that they can't count on government to lead in this time. But we are different in Massachusetts. We have always punched above our weight. And in my view, it's exactly because of what we're seeing nationally that Massachusetts is gonna rise up and be clear on November 8th who we stand with and what we stand for. You got that? That's what this is about. So go now and talk to people. Get them out. Make them understand that this is their democracy. This is what democracy is all about. And in a time, if anyone feels hopeless, if anyone feels without a voice, this is your time. This is their time. So I implore you, the next 10 days, let's leave it all on the court. Let's knock every door. Let's make every phone call. Let's send every text and email, because these kids are worth it. These kids are what it's about. And I promise you, I will be a governor and join with other colleagues in government who sees you, who listens to you, and who delivers for you. Let's go, Massachusetts.
First and then community power second, okay? Ready, go.
Who's got the power?
Union power.
What kind of power?
Union power.
Who's got the power?
We got the power.
What kind of power? Community power. All right, we're gonna close. We're gonna close this out. Indulge me one more second. It's Filipino Heritage Month. And I am Filipino. And this is International Worker Solidarity, so I'm going to teach you a chant in my language, Tagalog, okay? Are you ready? So, it's a call and response. So I'm going to say, Maki Baka, and you're going to say, Wag Ma Dakot. And then you guys say, Wag Ma Dakot, and then I say, Maki Baka. And that means fight without fear. All right, we're going to practice. Don't worry, we're going to practice. Maki baka, matakot, wag matakot, maki baka. Okay? One more time. Maki baka, wag matakot, wag matakot, maki baka. All right? We did it? One more? Ayana says one more time. All right. Maki baka. Y'all, thank you. Fight without fear always. Because when we fight, we win. Okay, so now we're going to close it out this beautiful morning and get us all energized to hit the doors. We would like you to welcome you to turn your bodies towards that dance troupe over there. Turn your whole body to that beautiful set of dancers. We want to welcome Area 51 Majorette Dance Team, Boston's first Majorette Dance Team, founded in 2017 by Destiny Neal. Area 51's nonprofit organization serves the youth of Boston to give them something fun, innovative, and productive to do through the art of dance. Please give it up for Posty and the Area 51 Majorette Dance Team.
Oh. Area 51.
What's going on, man? How you doing? You doing? Good to see you. Not mine. Thanks anyway.
Together, and I'm going to be a governor who sees everyone,
not let it divide people.
Can you talk about the importance of question one and question four and why Massachusetts voters should look at those on the ballot?
Well, question one is about money is really important. Investment in education and infrastructure is really important. We have sustained revenue to take care of our schools, to modernize our schools, to make sure that our students and our educators have the resources that they need, including wraparound services in schools. And then when it comes to question four, it's really a matter of public safety. We want to make sure that people have access to driver's licenses so we know who's on the roads, we know that they're trained, and if they have a car, they have access to insurance.
Gotcha. And I also just want...
Can I have you move over here real quick, please?
Yeah.
So we can have both of her, like, on camera? Thank you.
Yeah.
All right. You're good.
Okay. Would you like to go?
No, go ahead.
Okay. I also just wanted to ask, you would be the first LGBTQ plus governor of Massachusetts, and why is that important? Why is that representation important?
Representation matters, seen as believing. I know that having been elected the country's first openly gay attorney general, a lot of young people come up to me and tell me that that meant something to them because it showed them that certain barriers that they may not have been there in their way, in terms of their ability to go places and do things, weren't there. And if I can provide that kind of hope to others out there, I'm happy to do that.
What's next in the next 10 days? What's next for you?
More of this. Just getting out, going to rallies, campus kickoffs, encouraging people to get out and knock doors and make phone calls. There's a lot of energy and a lot of excitement around the state. People are desperate to have relief when it comes to prices, affordability, particularly around housing, transportation, childcare, and just cost of living. And so these are the things that I'm talking about. These are the things that I've made a priority as governor and want to deliver on. And that's what the next 10 days are going to be about, making sure that we're out there with our message to the voters, and voters understand that Kim Driscoll and I are going to be about delivering for people and not dividing them.
In short and sweet, for those that still don't know about you or what you're about, what's your message to them and why they should vote for you?
Look, I've been your attorney general. I have the experience to lead this state. I know what it takes to work together. I'm a ball player and a point guard. I know how to lead and work together as a team. I'm a kid who grew up in a small town, the oldest of five, raised by a single mom, learned a lot about sacrifice and hard work, and I have every intention to meet people where they are in this state, because people right now are hurting. They're dealing with real issues around affordability, and I understand that, and I'll be a governor who's looking to address that.
Perfect. Thank you.
Okay, thanks, guys. Great. All right, nice to meet you.
What's up, my man? How you doing?
Hey, what's up, man?
What up, dude? What's up, man?
What's up?
Working hard or how are you working?
Yeah.
Doing so. Yeah.
All right. All right.
How you doing?
Good to see you. What's up, man? What you been up to? Hold on to it, sure.
I'm going to go in the room.
How you doing? Alright guys, that pretty much wraps it up. I'll do a quick pass around so you can see all the people that did show up. Alright guys, that pretty much wraps it up. Anything else comes up, I get back to you.
Andrea Campbell. Also, yes, on 4. This is a matter of safety on our roads. Regardless of immigration status, if you call the Commonwealth of Massachusetts your home and you are a resident, yes on 4, so that every driver is tested, insured, and licensed. It's a matter of safety, and it's also a matter of economic mobility. So that's why we felt it important to be here. We've been moving throughout the Massachusetts 7th and coalition with this movement and canvassers just to get the word out. Okay, in that I represent the Massachusetts 7th, which is one of the most unequal districts in the country, the most unequal in this delegation. You know, public safety, I believe, begins with public health. That's why we're here fighting and mobilizing around yes on 1, so that we can get those investments, those equitable investments in community that support the stabilization and health of families and community. We also have to not only focus on prevention, but also focus on intervention strategies, and then also trauma response, because that is leaving a residual and reverberating impact for generations. So it requires collective effort. It requires vigilance. My heart goes out to any family who's been impacted by this violence. And there's more that we have to do, but for me it begins with investment and stabilization of family and community, because I really do see violence so often as a byproduct of poverty. So that's why we're fighting for these investments today. Okay.
Appreciate it.